So a quick question I get asked tons of times is, what is a diff locker? Or most of us just call them a locker. So what is it, when to use it, and how does it work? That's what we're gonna run through right now. So I've set up a bit of a stage. I'm running full pressures just to get myself a bit of a pickle. I could lower the pressures a fair bit more and probably drive this a little bit easier, but that wouldn't help this video very much. So just gonna show you where we're at the moment. So I'm caught up on a tree root here. I'm obviously lacking traction, which is a bit of the problem. I wanna go forward. Shaley stuff has caught me up here. So to get a bit more forward drive, a bit more motion forward, we're gonna put the locker on and see how she goes. Currently caught up with that tree root, so we're just gonna explain what a locker does before I engage it and make it happen. So before we do that, you need to understand what a diff is. So a diff is kind of short for differential. So basically you got, at the back end, you got two sets of wheels and they spin independently. So basically one spins faster than the other, which is, you know, great for on the road, good to keep it going. But in an off-road situation, if one's in the air or one is lacking traction, they're gonna spin independently. So you got, so I want equal. And that's just gonna get me out of this little problem, which is gonna be pretty easy to do. And that's what the locker does. So flicking a switch, everything goes. What you don't wanna do, and this is, I've been caught out myself a couple of times, in the front of these things, you got a locker in the front and you're just using it. Just hit the two buttons, go, go, berserk. What's gonna happen is, as the car's driving and independently, they're not locked in the middle. So they're driving independently, different speeds. You go up on a ledge and you bounce that, zero problem. If you got a locker and it's going at the same thing, this thing's bound and you bounce that, kaboom, you got parts everywhere, all sorts of problems. Wheels start coming together because you're gonna do a tie rod at the same time, CVs go flying. Looks great for about 30 seconds. It's gonna cost you a couple of days. So be smart with your locker, don't use it every time. And you'll see a lot of us drive, we'll drive, back it up, drive, try a slightly different angle. Lockers are not the first thing you do, because that's gonna be the first thing you break. They're not cheap, takes a bit of time to put another locker in, a fair bit of money. Worst case, your weekend's busted. So be smart with your locker. In this situation, Aaron spot me around, we've got a good plan, we're just gonna drive out of here nice and easy. So use it when you need it, and basically don't break anything. So here we go, let's check this out. All right, so that was us running without the locker. You can see the different speeds that's going on. Now, gonna put the lockers in. I'm just gonna crawl up this hill easily. All right, so it's pretty easy to do. Basically, I was hooked up a little bit. Just had to move around off that tree where it was holding me back, and I had no traction because one of the wheels was just almost in the air, not fully in the air. I am running 40 PSI, so that's not ideal for that situation. I reckon if I dropped it all the way down, probably would have got close to driving it, but wouldn't have been able to show you guys what the lockers are doing. So put the lockers in carefully, smartly, not too much bouncing going on. I was able just to get the traction and up, and that was pretty simple to do with the lockers. Now, in a lot of situations in big jumps, be careful what you're doing. And if you're not any good at driving and it's your first time forward driving and you just slam in lockers, you're gonna break stuff. So use your minds and go with some experience and you're not gonna have any problems there. So yeah, that was pretty easy. On to the next one.